So in regards to candidates, let's first specifically talk about Parkinson's disease. So the best candidates for Parkinson's disease are those patients who have moderate disease, meaning that medications are effective, but not as effective as they used to be. They have a good time when they're responding to medications, but they have what's called fluctuations. So at one point, they'll be on and doing very well, but then all of a sudden, it'll be like they were completely off their medications. And at that point, they're also sometimes developing significant side effects from the medications. One of the most significant side effects is something called dyskinesias, and that's generally described as a sort of a writhing movement. Patients have a hard time sitting still. It's at the time where patients are having side effects from the medications and the on-off fluctuations that generally they can be considered candidates for deep brain stimulation surgery. At the same time, we don't want patients who have far advanced Parkinson's disease either. So if a patient is primarily wheelchair-bound or bed-bound or has significant symptoms of dementia or memory loss, that might be too late for them to really have the surgery.